Hello, YouTube and fellow DC Comic fans. I'm Keith OneShot, and this is my dramatic reading series. And today, we will be covering Batman Issue 32, The War of Jokes and Riddles, Part 8, from DC Comics. We start this story off with Bruce Wayne and Selina Kyle sitting down on a bed. Bruce looks down in sadness. Then Selina leans forward to check on him. Bruce then puts his hands on his head. Then Selina comforts him. We then see several of the faces of the people who were killed during the War of Jokes and Riddles by both the Riddler and Joker's army, innocent lives that were lost in the crossfire. We then see the Riddler, the Joker, and Batman all staring at each other, ready to finish the fight. We then go back to the present day with Bruce and Selina. Selina holds Bruce's hand, then Bruce kisses Selina's hand, then he looks her right in the eyes. Back during the war, we see Joker and the Riddler both charge at Batman. Then the Riddler says, "Finally!" Then Batman trips the Joker, then he blocks a punch from the Riddler. The Riddler then punches Batman in the face, then Batman blocks another punch, then Batman knocks the Riddler to the ground. The Joker then runs behind Batman and smashes him in the back with a light pole. Batman then turns around and cracks Joker in the face. Then, the Riddler cracks a chair over Batman's head. Batman does his best to hold them both off. Then he quickly dodges and moves out of the way of the Joker's strike, which misses and hits the Riddler instead. Then, Batman punches Joker and knocks him back to the ground. Then the Riddler and Batman each exchange blows until Batman has the upper hand. Then in a rage, Batman keeps punching the Riddler. The Riddler cries out, "Mercy! Mercy, please! Mercy!" Then Batman, who's on top of the Riddler, then says, "Mercy?" The Riddler shouts, "Yes, I lose. You win. Fine. Marvelous. Now tell me, I can't see over your thighs. Is he laughing?" Batman replies, "What?" And Riddler says, "The Joker, you twit. He should be laughing. Is he laughing?" We then see that Joker has an angry look on his face. Then Batman tells Riddler,
"I don't know. What do you think?"
Then Joker says, "No." Then, Riddler shouts out in anger, "No? Why, it should have been enough. Wage a war. Take you, the city, the bat, all to the brink, only to lose. Because of what? Kite Man. I'm humiliated, defeated, beaten in front of you, because of Kite Man. Do you know how much work it took to create a foil named Kite Man? To set him up as the informant, to kill his kid, to convince Batman to leave him for last, knowing you'd come here, knowing Kite Man could lead everyone here. Me, defeated by Kite Man, begging mercy from Batman. That's funny? You should be laughing." Then Joker says, "Knock, knock." Then Batman says, "Enough!" And the Riddler replies, "This isn't about you, you idiot! How did you ever? Not every story is your story. You really think it bothers me you're alive? I could kill you easily. I could kill everyone you love. If I wanted, you'd all be in a ditch tomorrow. I keep you alive for the reason we all keep you alive. You're that first riddle you hear when you're a child, that you return to as an adult. Though you know the answer, you're not a challenge, but you're fun." Then, the Riddler tells Joker, "But you, the man who laughs at anything, but who now can't laugh anymore." Then, the Joker says, "Who's there? Incompetent interrupting cow." Then the Riddler says, "That is an opportunity. That's a riddle I want to solve, that I did solve, by making this war, by losing this war, and you, you should be laughing." We then hear Bruce Wayne in the present day tell Selina Kyle,
"Kite Man's son, Charlie, I was there. After Enigma poisoned him, killed him, to solve a riddle, to tell a damn joke. Charlie asked his father if he said that word, the bad word, would he go to the bad place. His father told him no, but Charlie didn't hear that. He was already gone."
We then go back to the fight during the war, where the Riddler says to Joker, "Didn't you get it?" And Joker replies, "Incompetent interrupting cow who?" The Riddler then shouts, "Do I have to explain it to you? Are you that stupid?" Then Batman pulls out a knife. The Riddler then shouts at Batman, "Wait, are you? No!" Then Joker says,
"Moo!"
And Riddler screams, "No!" Then Batman smiles and says,
"Hell yeah!"
We then go back to the present day, where Bruce tells Selina, "It wasn't an accident. I didn't think I'd fail. I wasn't out of control or insane. I knew who I was. I knew what I was doing. I understood the choice I'd made. I thrust the knife out to kill the Riddler, and the Joker stopped me." We then go back to the war, where Batman stabs at the Riddler with his knife, but the Joker blocks the knife with his hand and gets stabbed through it. The Joker then smiles and says, "Now, that's funny." Then the Joker begins laughing. We then go back to the present day, where Bruce tells Selina, "Later in Arkham, I asked the Joker why he'd saved me. He asked me if I knew the difference between a joke and a riddle. I said no. He said when I figured that out, I'd understand. Then Bruce looks down in sadness and says,
"What separates me from them? I have lines, right? I can stop. I have limits. They can't control themselves. I can. I'm good. They're bad. They kill. I don't."
Then Bruce stands up and walks to the window. Then he says,
"That's what everyone thinks, but it's not true. What separates me from them is a hand on a knife. His hand. And now you know. I'm not noble. I'm not some knight in the dark. I'm just what he made me."
Then Bruce sits down next to Selena, and Selena says,
"Bat."
And Bruce replies,
"Cat, I love you. I have to love you. But that doesn't mean it isn't. I'm... You don't have to love me."
Then Selena stands up and says to Bruce, "What's the difference between a joke and a riddle?" And Bruce replies,
"Cat."
Then Selena stands up and walks over to the window. Then she says,
"The answer could be clever, or funny, or political, or deep, or anything. It could be, but it's not. The answer is, who cares? You are who he made. Fine. And I'm whatever the horrors of my life made me. Fine. All of our sins, our earned tragedies, all of it, all that damn pain, it's all here with us. It is us. And I'm sure it's all meaningful, or hilarious, or philosophical, or deep, or something, or everything. We could spend our whole lives mired in the complexities, but really, compared to us, compared to you and me, what we have, or could have, all that pain we have, honestly, who cares?" Then Bruce says,
"Selena."
And Selena replies, "Bruce, say it again, but this time, you poor boy, don't demand. Please just ask me." Then Bruce Wayne looks at Selena Kyle, and he says to her,
"Will you marry me?"
Selena then smiles, and with tears coming from her eyes, she says,
"Yes."
And that ends today's story. Comic published by DC Comics. All rights, story art, and characters belong to DC Comics and their respective owners. Not me. This has been Batman Issue 32, The War of Jokes and Riddles, Part 8. And I'm your host, Keith OneShot. If you like this video, make sure to check out the rest of my Comic Complete dramatic reading series. And support DC Comics by picking up a copy of the trades and single issue comics. Support your local comic book shop. Take care and have a great day. Goodbye.